Good morning, all. So today we are going to talk about MIMO antennas, lens antennas, and reflector antennas. First, I will talk about MIMO antennas. Then we will go move on to reflector, and then followed by lens. Okay. So can you all see the screen? Can anyone confirm? Okay. Okay. Fine. Thank you. So MIMO antennas. I would like to give some brief introduction about MIMO antennas. Like this MIMO concept is proposed by Aarogyaswamy Pal Raj, who is from when we was working in Stanford University around 2000 or 1988. Okay, so later point of time, so that time it was not that picked up. Maybe though MIMO is used in many applications, but now it is extensively used in mobile networks, like cellular networks. So right from 4G, so till 3G there was no MIMO concept was there. There was carrier aggregation, so several other concept they used to enhance the data rates. But MIMO first introduced in LTE, that we call it as 4G. Okay, so that time it was not that used, because no, I think 8x8 MIMO was the maximum one. And now in 5G era, and it is completely it's been exploited. MIMO antennas are, you know, MIMO technology is exploited. Therefore, the MIMO requirement of MIMO antennas are, you know, hugely shooted up. And because, you know, 5G has several applications and several technologies going together, so therefore the requirement for MIMO enhancement of MIMO antennas and employing many combinations in MIMO antennas, so is going to be a challenge one. And it is that is where we find so many research forums to explore. Okay, so before we move on, let me give actually, as we are in 5G era, like though I should not call, but okay, because we are moving ahead of 5G era. So okay, so so far the coverage was like till 4G, the coverage was, you know, about a cell coverage. Okay, one pull sector you will have a coverage, then whether user is there or not, we don't bother. Okay, so now we are bothered, so because, you know, we have wastage of energy, so they are going for a beamforming concept. So MIMO along with the array concept. Okay, so they are beamforming. Okay, so therefore the, you know, here what they are ensuring, the signal to noise ratio improvement, and also the performance wise it is improved. Okay, so how does it work is, like, you know, you have a cell tower which is broadcasting in all direction beam. So one UE capture the beam, then it will keep on communicating with the cellular networks. When it find, you know, when it moving, then the time it will capture the nearby cell site coverage, and then it will, you know, hop up with that. Okay, so now why we go for MIMO, so that we will discuss now. Okay, so here you can see that the scenarios, like, you know, you can see here that trees are there, buildings are there. So when a vehicle moving behind the building, we are facing there is a, you know, drop in signal, right? So that case, so if you have a line of sight communication alone, then you can't, you know, establish a connection with the user who is behind the building or trees or any other blockage. Okay, so that is where they exploited in MIMO. What is done is that they are using, you know, making use of multipath signal to ensure the, you know, signal, and also the ensure the enhanced SNR. Okay, so next advantage is that in enhancing the throughput. So if you have a only one beam sweeping between the user, you can see here that, so only one beaming, you know, being communicated with each user. So here, so when you use multi-user MIMO, there we are ensuring that, you know, at a time two users are being served with the beams. Okay, so that is how we are enhancing the throughput. So remember, so today we are going to talk about two features only, majorly. So though it has many other features, but majorly one is to enhance the signal to noise ratio. Therefore, the data rate is enhanced, and the other one is that enhancing the throughput, like, you know, data rates by using multi-user MIMO. Okay, that's what we are going to talk about broadly. So before we move on, these are all the outline of my presentation. Like we start with the Shannon's capacity theorem, so that time we will understand so why we go for MIMO and all, and some introduction to MIMO and different diversity what we use in MIMO, and the different types of MIMO and MIMO. So MIMO, so the, how it can be implemented in how it is ensured in by with the help of antenna, MIMO antenna design, and what are all performance metric used for if you are designing an antenna, MIMO antenna, what are all performance metric to be evaluated, that we will see, and some of the MIMO antennas and with its characteristics we will just go through, and followed by how the MIMO is evolved in 5G, and also the how it has been designed, some of the simulation tools and testing we'll see. Okay, so first we'll start with the Shannon's capacity theorem. So what it says is that, so you have a capacity, so it is depending upon several parameters. So the straightforward parameter is enhancing the bandwidth. If you have enough band, you can send so much data, and then you can you can get the enhanced throughput. But the problem is the spectrum is as much costlier. You might have seen in last week in news that Jio got in lakhs of crore or they have spent for fetching the 100 megahertz or 20 megahertz, 100 megahertz or 120 megahertz bandwidth. Okay, so that much is the costly about the bandwidth. Okay, so simply using the wider bandwidth, it does not serve our purpose because spectrum is much costlier. So what is the other way? So the other way is that enhancing the number of antennas, increasing the number of RX antennas, therefore you can capture these signals, so then you'll do signal processing, and then you decode the data properly, and so that you can enhance the data rate. Next is SNR, so improving SNR. So how we are going to improve SNR in MIMO? So here they are going to make use of multipath signal. So and also they do the signal processing at either at transmitter receiver side, and then capture the signal, so that you are enhancing the throughput. The fourth one is that number of TX antennas also. So instead of number of RX, you can have a number of TX. Why? Because for example, if you are going for a mobile handset, you cannot implement 32x32 MIMO because handset is so handy. So you can increase, you can implement at least 8x8 MIMO maximum. But beyond, if you go beyond that, then it will be a too much complex design. So that's why they implement a number of number of TX number of TX antenna, RX antenna. Why I'm saying is that you can implement that you can increase the number of antennas in the base station side. So therefore the transmitting side you have not many antennas to improve the data rate. Okay. Next is that channel matrix. So improving, increasing the number of antennas itself does not serve purpose, because if you are increasing the antennas, the channel path it is going to follow. It will be number of channel paths. It's going to, for example, you have several antennas are there. So each will transmit in its own channel path. So in channel, we are going to see a lot many complex thing. So therefore, there will be a constructive and destructive interference may happen. And also the isolation between these two paths are we are not sure. So that's why we are going to employ channel matrix and also the signal processing in order to enhance the throughput. So these are all the way we can enhance the throughput or capacity of a system. Okay, so now let's move on to MIMO. So what is MIMO? So it is multiple input and multiple output. So this is the Wikipedia definition, that it is a method multiplying capacity of a radio link using multiple transmission and receiving antennas to exploit multipath propagation. This is the Wikipedia definition. So it is self-explanatory. You can see here that TX, you have a number of antenna, multiple number of antennas. You have RX, you have multiple number of antennas, and you are doing for example, this antenna is receiving signal from first 1, 2, 3, and you are doing channel matrix, and then you are decoding the data. And you are sending different data in a different path, and then you are decoding data at the same time, therefore the enhanced throughput. And so as I said before, so we are going to use the MIMO, that is multipath propagation, right? So how we are going to use, one second. Okay, so how we are going to use that, you can see that. So you are having your mobile which has two antennas. Okay, so how it is going to receive from the signals are coming from different direction due to multipath effect. So this is how this multipath propagation will happen. Okay, so the first method is that time diversity. So time diversity is nothing but you have a set of data, so you want to send. Okay, so you are sending in different time slots. So therefore, you are with the existing. So by making use of same channel and the same resource, you are making use of them, and using time diversity, you are enhancing the data rate. As next is that frequency diversity. The frequency diversity is that you have two antennas are co-located. Okay, two antennas, but each one is operating in two different frequency. Therefore, there is high isolation is isolation is ensured between the two antennas. Then you can send the one traffic, one set of data in this antenna. You can send another set of data in this antenna. So that's where this frequency diversity is may come into picture. Third one is that space diversity. So you don't have multiple frequency or time slots. Also, we cannot do beyond certain thing because you are going to use one antenna. You are going to send the data in different time slots, right? So space diversity, what they will do is, so if you do not have the above two option, what they will do is they will keep two antennas co-located. So both are isolated in the form of either by if you talk in terms of antenna design, either by spatially or using pattern diversity. Okay, so that we will discuss later. So therefore, the one antenna will send a set of data, the other antenna set will send another set of data. Therefore, you are enhancing the, ideally it should get, you should get double the capacity, but in practice it may not be possible because there is no complete isolated channel is ensured. So that's why so space diversity gives some kind of enhancement in throughput. Okay, so now MIMO modes. So what is MIMO modes? First one is that how we are implementing this. So first one is that spatial diversity, and the next one is that spatial multiplexing. So as we said sometime before, so capacity is also directly proportional to SNR, right? So if you are improving the SNR, therefore you can increase the So spatial diversity means what? So you are having a number of transmitting antennas. Okay, you have a number of receiving antennas. So you will have a direct signal coming to, for example, TX2 to RX2, TX1 to RX1. Okay, so you will also have a multipath signal coming from it will be hitting on this tree and then come to here, and also it will hitting on some building and comes to here. So how we are going to effectively use this multipath? For example, by effectively using this multipath signal, you can send the, for example, one data in this path and the other data in this path. So that's how we are improving the, that is one way. Okay, that is capacity enhancement. The other way is that you will send the same data in both the channel and then receive it whichever is better. Okay, so that's, I think, maximal ratio combining. So several algorithm you might have studied in your communication theory, that Rayleigh fading and all those stuff, right? So how you are going to combine the signal which is having which better SNR, right? So that's how we use. Okay, but in antenna perspective, you can design antenna either by, so for example, if you want to achieve the spatial diversity, you can do it in two ways. One is simply placing the antenna one here and the other here. Okay, you are ensuring the isolation between these two antennas. That is called as spatial diversity. Okay, the other concept is that you are going to place the two antennas very close to each other. But the thing is that, so by doing some kind of mechanism, you are ensuring the pattern diversity. For example, this antenna will radiate in one direction, this antenna will radiate in another direction. So that is where we can ensure the pattern diversity. So in both the case, we are achieving the diversity performance. Okay, the second is that, so it is nothing but, so in different, so we MIMO has different paths. One is direct path, other one is through multipaths, right? So Here, what we are going to use, we are going to use this multipath effectively. Therefore, you know, one data will be sent in this path, other data will be sent in another path, the other data will be sent in another path. So therefore, the, you know, your additional data capacity is ensured. Okay, so let's see here an example, like a kind of animation. You can see here that so one data is sent like this and reaching here, another data is sent like this and reaching here. So you know, all the paths we are sending the data, therefore the capacity is enhanced. Okay, so final ultimate goal is that we are enhancing the throughput by doing spatial multiplexing. Okay, the first one is enhanced in the SNR, the second one is enhanced in the throughput straight away. Okay, so here enhanced in the SNR, indirectly it is enhanced in the capacity also. Okay, so next is that MIMO types. So one is single input, single output. So that is the conventional communication any communication device has. Okay, second thing is that single input, multiple output. Here you can see that so receiver has multiple antennas, so where we can do switched diversity, which means see you are receiving the same signal at both the antennas, whichever gives better SNR, then I will decode the data and then process it for further. Okay, and maximal ratio combining, so that these are all the two processes happens. Third is that SIMO, MOSI. Okay, here the processing, here actually, you know, here we need some kind of processing at the receiver side in order to decode the data properly. So here multiple input and single output is that. So here the processing is moved from RX to TX. So both are same, but the where we are processing based on that, it is either called a SIMO or MISO. Okay, so next is that MIMO, multi-user MIMO. Okay, so here you can see that so at a time you can four devices or eight devices based on the MIMO configuration that you implement. For example, if you are using 4x4 MIMO, you can use, you know, four devices can be served at a time. So the here we are ensuring the spatial diversity and also the spatial multiplexing. So therefore we are enhancing the data rate. Okay, next is that massive MIMO. So till LTE this was the scenario, simply multi-user MIMO was there, but in 5G we have massive MIMO, so which is nothing but so here the antenna element, each antenna element is the will serve for only one, it's a single element. Okay, whereas in massive MIMO each antenna element is an array. Okay, so here what we are doing is each array, each MIMO element is an phased array. Okay, so each, and if you are using 4x4 or 8x8 MIMO, so based on that you will get a different kind of beams based on the excitation with the element. Okay, so then you are getting, you know, azimuth and as well as the elevation beam forming. You might have studied in the antenna theory that azimuth direction is this, elevation direction is this. Vertical you call it as elevation, azimuth you call it as horizontal. So beam can be swept in both the directions. Why? Because see, those user are there in the ground where we need azimuthal beam forming. Those user are in the building, right? We need elevation beam form to communicate with the each user. So this is how it works. Like you can see here that so beams are triggered in a different direction and it is communicating with the users. Okay, now how antenna technologies evolved in the in cellular technologies, that in 2G we had only single input, single output, and also 3G also we had some single input, single output, but some smartness introduced in the 3G. But apart from that, there was no much on that. Okay, but in 4G, MIMO is implemented. But in 5G, we have massive MIMO along with the beamforming, which means that is beamforming is done by array. Okay, so here in base station, we have massive MIMO where we'll have thousands of elements and elements will be there. Because each MIMO element is an array. Array will have many elements. So combinedly, you can see that thousands of elements will be there. So, but in UE point of view, it is an N-cross-N, 4x4 or 8x8 or 32x32 MIMO antennas are there. So, okay. And also the antenna arrays we have. Okay. So if you can see here that FR2 only we are talking about this beamforming antenna arrays. Why? Because see, FR1 FR2 means FR1 is nothing but around below 6 gigahertz, not as exactly 6 gigahertz, it is 7.125 gigahertz below is called as FR1. FR2 is nothing but a millimeter wave, okay, that is beyond 26 gigahertz, okay. So in 26 gigahertz the problem is you cannot have line of sight for longer distance. So that time we are going for a beamforming approach, because for example when a user here, okay, it is getting blocked by someone or some building or entry. So what we are doing is that, so in order to avoid that, for example if you have a cell kind of coverage, so this particular area is going to be the whatever power you transmit in this area, it is going to be wasted, okay. That's why they go for a beamforming approach. So when you do beamforming, what will happen is enhanced gain is ensured, therefore distance of coverage is enhanced, okay. That we will see subsequently. Next is that advantages of MIMO is, first foremost thing is that spectral efficiency, because with the existing spectrum, by increasing the number of antennas we are enhancing the spectral efficiency. So next is the superior data rates, because we are going to use multipath effectively in order to enhance the data rate, and also the coverage range we are going to enhance, because range of coverage is going to be enhanced, and reliability is increased, because you are enhancing the data rate with good amount of reliability, higher SNR, that is we have discussed, better energy efficiency, okay. So in for LTE device and when compared to in 5G and all, they are going to talk about low battery, like a battery consumption is going to be reduced drastically, because by employing this MIMO technology. Because for example in 2G mobile, for example if you will have only one antenna, okay. So when you are moving towards the edge of the cell, then your battery will dry frequently. When you are traveling, you will see so many cell edges. So the handover happens, okay, between one cell to another cell. So that time it will dry, battery will be drained easily, because you have only one antenna to receive that signal. But in MIMO you will have multiple antennas, so you can receive somehow and then enhance the battery efficiency. Next is that enhances signal quality, cell edges, reject interferences. These are all implemented in in 5G, and also the in 4G reject interference is there, because you have a mobile and you have a cell site, okay, you have a cell site, so it will be transmitting signal, okay. So your mobile will receive this signal, and also the other signal which is in the environment, which is nearby that band, some band, okay. For example, if you are using 2.1 gigahertz, so nearby that band you will have multiple devices are operating, and so that is emitting some signal. So here we are doing some kind of signal processing in order to reject these interferences, okay. Next is that, this is what I was telling, so if you have a cell type of coverage, whether a user is there or not, you have to keep on sending the power, okay, in the entire cell. But in 5G what we are doing is that, so you are going to use a beamforming approach, therefore the wherever user is there, the beam will be triggered, and other place you will not see any beams. So there are the two advantages are there. One is preserving the energy in the base station side, because you are not going to transmit in the entire region, you are going to transmit for each device. Second is that by means of narrow beam you can enhance the coverage range also, because a third advantage is that whether user is in nearby cell tower or edge of the cell, we're going to be receive same kind of signal rays, okay. So this is another example where you can see that several devices are coming, and then you are having MIMO. Next is that, okay, so now we have seen that, okay, MIMO, about more about MIMO. So now we talk about in terms of MIMO antenna. So before we move on, we'll just see, you have designed the antenna. So what are all parameter to be kept in mind while designing the MIMO antenna, okay, that we will see later, and then we will see some of the antennas, okay. The first and foremost parameter is envelope correlation coefficient. So what does this mean? So you have two antennas are co-located, okay. So when you excite both antennas, what happens is, when you excite both antennas, so these two will talk to each other, right? So either by, you know, for example, both are in the same board, right? So through surface current it can talk, or you know, when it radiates, it will have a radiation pattern kind of something like this. It will have another radiation, this antenna will have a radiation pattern like this. Okay, so there should be a some kind of correlation, so which is unavoidable and also the undesirable. So in order to measure that, we have the parameter called correlation envelope, correlation coefficient. Okay, so how much is the isolation ensured between two element of MIMO? So this is the first and prime most parameter. It can be estimated using radiation pattern or S parameter. So how S parameter works? Radiation pattern, I have shown that, okay, two radiation patterns are there. If it overlap, then you know you will have some kind of coupling. Okay, so coupling. So in simple words, what we can see is that, so you have two antennas which are in the same board. You have a same PCB. So you are exciting two antennas. So here on the ground there will be surface currents. So the whatever surface current you know generated by here, you know, fed here, it may be get coupled with the here. Okay, so what we want to measure first, what I have to measure, how much is the reflection coefficient. Okay, so how much is getting reflected, how much is getting coupled, that is by for example, if it is a two element MIMO, you can measure S12 or S21 to, and then by using those two parameters you are going to calculate this envelope correlation coefficient using this equation. Okay, it should be zero, ideally zero, but it may not be zero, but it should be as low as possible. Okay, next is that total active reflection coefficient. So we cannot, you know, in practical environment we cannot only talk about conventional scattering parameters. We have to go use a total active reflection coefficient. How it is evaluated is that total reflected power square root of total reflected power divided by total incident power. Okay, so that is where it is calculated. This again is estimated using S parameters. So for two element MIMO, this is the formula to calculate the total active reflection coefficient. The third parameter is that mean effective gain. Okay, so you have a two antenna element. Okay, sorry, you have a MIMO antenna. So when you measure when you simulate, you are simulating in a controlled environment, right? And also when you measure, also you will measure in the anechoic chamber. That is also a controlled environment. But in practice, you will not see any controlled environment. Okay, so that is where this calculation is useful, because you know you are going to measure your gain in the certain emulated environment, we can say. Because you know we cannot we can measure one way is that you can just deploy your antenna in some device and then measure in the real time environment. That is not much feasible, because we have to get some kind of agreement with the or license for the measurement and all, because we have to get some approval. Okay, instead of that, what we can do is, in simulation tool also now it has been implemented, like how we can apply some kind of signal models, signal propagation models, channel models, and then do the gain calculation. So that is called as mean effective gain. Okay, the fourth parameter is that diversity gain. So diversity means, see, you have one antenna here, one antenna here. Okay, so as individual element it may give some kind of 8 dB gain. Okay, so when you combine these two, we should get some kind of improved gain, right? So otherwise there is no point, because otherwise we cannot enhance the signal to noise ratio. Okay, so this parameter is mainly meant for that. So how much is the diversity antenna, for example, if you are going for a space diversity, how much has the diversity antenna enhances the SNR? That's what we are going to measure. So it is nothing but it is calculated using this formula here, the gamma c. This one is that, so how much power, how much SNR, instantaneous SNR we are getting when we apply diversity. So ideally you should get power, because double the SNR, because you are using two antennas. Okay, if it is isolated environment, there is no correlation between these two channel, then you will get double the SNR, but it is not possible in practice. So what it does is, so how they are estimating this one, what they are doing is that, so when you so how much is the SNR when you have a diversity included, and then how much is the SNR when you have a single antenna alone, single system alone. So based on that, they are calculating this diversity gain. Next is that branch power ratio. So what does it mean? So you have two MIMO antennas, okay? So one antenna is fed with high power, another antenna is fed with very low power. So if you have a deviation too much, then you cannot ensure the diversity, or you cannot ensure the MIMO inherent characteristics of MIMO. So the power difference also should not be too much, okay? That is what is the defines, okay? Branch power is P, minimum power that is applied in one terminal within the MIMO. What is the maximum power is, for example, you cannot have a very high power, and you cannot have a very low power. So the difference between the ratio between these two should be as minimal as possible. So then only you will ensure that your required performance is ensured. Okay, how it is related? Mean effective gain, because as I mentioned here, so it is the channel that dictates this, because if you are exerting high power here, low power here, so when it propagates in the channel, this will have so much fading, right? So this signal will reach end user, but this signal may not reach. So therefore, you are having antenna, but it will remain unusable. Okay. So that's why we have to ensure that branch power ratio should be maintained as low as possible. Okay. So the difference between the power excited between two antennas should be maintained as low as possible. Difference should be as low as possible. The sixth parameter is that system capacity. So we have to ensure that, so we are implementing 2x2 MIMO or 4x MIMO, 4x4 MIMO or 8x8 MIMO. So how much is the space capacity increases? That we will do measurement. I think some of the softwares are available to do this measurement and all. Okay. Now let's see some of the MIMO antennas. Okay, the simple MIMO antennas. So you can see here that this is one port, this is another port. Okay. So here what they are doing is that both are co-located very closely, okay? And so by employing these two, here what they have done is that they are isolated these two antennas by employing this kind of SRR kind of thing, okay? So how they are ensuring? So what is the parameter first we will measure S11. You can see that this parameter is S11 is resonating at this frequency. And S11, S21 is the coupling between two antennas is very low, below 30 dB. That's what we can see here. Okay. So now in pattern wise also it is completely isolated. So when you exit this antenna, we are getting this kind of pattern. When you are exiting this antenna, we are getting a complete, exactly orthogonal pattern, right? So now we can employ this for spatial diversity application, where we can send the one data in this using this antenna, another data in this using this antenna, because the pattern is completely orthogonal, so there will not be much correlation between these two ports. Okay, this is how we are ensuring using pattern diversity. Next is that MIMO antenna. So the another kind of MIMO antennas are that. So you can see that placement of element. Okay. So in order to ensure isolation between each element, placement of element. So how we are going to place, which direction this element is going to be placed, and also some of the mutual coupling reduction mechanism. So here you can see that, so you are exiting this port, but there is no coupling with the other ports. That's what we are sometime before I am mentioning envelope correlation coefficient, see how much is the low. So it should be as low as possible. It should be very close to zero, okay? Because there is no correlation between them. Similarly, other antenna, you can see here that here there some kind of slots here in order to ensure the isolation between two antennas. You can see here that based on from the surface current, we can see that it is completely isolated. Okay, here this antenna is exited. You can see that there is no coupling with this. Okay. And also pattern diversity also it is ensured. So this antenna is radiating in this direction, this antenna is radiating this direction. Okay. Similarly, there are multiple antennas are there. If you type MIMO antennas in the literature, IEEE Explorer or Google Scholar, you will get lakhs and lakhs of papers. Okay. So here, this author have deployed a dual band MIMO antenna. You can see that though it is connected, but via by using shorting pin, he could establish, you know, isolation between two antennas, and also the dual band he could achieve. So this is one operating in one band, this is operating in another band. Okay, that you can see in the see, this is one band, this is another band. Okay, as you can see in the S parameter thing here, you can see that the placement of element in a different fashion, so that, you know, he could ensure that isolation is you know, enhanced. Okay, and the fourth one is that it is, you can see that it's a highly complex. Okay, we can see that, so he is using a multiband antenna, and you can see that how many ports are there, port 3, port 4, port 2, port 1, so several ports are there. So how much complex is the design? So this is how the mobile device will have. Okay, this is how it will be. The design will be not simple as this. Okay, in a mobile device it will be the design will be this much complex. Okay, when you now let's see how the MIMO antennas, it's a basically application of MIMO antennas in 5G. Okay, so how it is deployed now in 5G MIMO system. You will have, for example, coding or modulation. You have a source, and then you will do pre-processing and all. Baseband communication will happen. Okay, then coding and modulation, which will be given to beamforming and MIMO processing. Okay, so now we are giving to beamforming and MIMO processing. Then do the IFFT. Okay, and then give to the digital to analog converter. Then it will be fed to the RF front end module. Okay, this is the kind of, you know, beamforming network. Okay, so through which we'll excite to the each of the antenna element. Okay. So what it happened is, you can see that you can trigger a beam in this direction, in this direction. So for example, you have four devices are connected. So each device is, you know, for example, this is serving one device, this is serving another device, this is serving another device. This is how you are ensuring the enhancing the data rate, and also the ensuring the independent communication channel. Okay. So as I said before, each MIMO element in 5G is the array. Okay, this is how it will be looking like. So 8x8 array, 4x4 array. So these are all the array. So when you increase the number of elements in the array, you can dedicate the beam for each element. Okay, that's how it works. You can see here that. So here the 4x4 antenna array, your beam of coverage is beam width is somewhat large. It can cover a particular kind of a hotspot, we can say. Okay, but when you increase the number of antennas in the array, okay, and then number of antenna elements in the array, you are, you know, you can trigger the, you know, you can transmit the narrow beam also. Okay, so therefore you can serve each and a mobile element individually. Okay, whereas here you can see that still it is a kind of a subcell, because, you know, here you are radiating in this full area, where if your devices are there or not, you will be transmitting. But whereas here, wherever device is there, we are pointing the beam towards that particular direction. Okay. Now, this is how it will be a high level design of a 5G MIMO system. Okay. So this is how it will be looking like. You can see that baseband interface, and then beamforming device will be there. Beamforming network means, so basically we are, you know, calculating the excitation of each element. Okay, then next is digital radio processing. This is, we call it as RF front end. Okay, there we will have antennas and power amplifiers and low noise amplifiers. For example, if it is a TX-RX, low noise amplifier, mixer, so all those elements will be there. Okay, now let's see how evolved antennas evolved. This I could have given explained before, but let's see. Okay, so 1G we had a wire kind of antennas. Okay, in 2G, 2.5G we had a printed antennas. So this external antenna brought inside the mobile. Okay, now 3G we had, you know, several antennas were there on the which supports Wi-Fi, GPS and GSM, UMTS. Okay, and in 4G they first introduced this MIMO antennas. Okay, where let me show you one more picture, so later. And 5G, you can see that several MIMO antennas, it has to support 4G as well as 5G, where 4G will have its own MIMO system and 5G will have its own MIMO system. This is about mobile. Okay, base station antenna wise, simple base station antenna will have this kind of antennas. Okay, panel antennas and all. Next, 3G to 4G, you can see that multiple ports are, you know, multiple antennas are co-located together, each antenna will work in different bands, and also the GSM, 3G, 4G and all, okay. But in 5G, you can see that this much complex is the antenna design. You can see that number of ports are increasing, and this is the antenna designed by Samir. You can see that 32 transmitter, 32 receiver, massive MIMO antenna. So inside the view, I didn't find in the internet. So I could see that. So this many connectors are going to be connected. Okay. Next is that you can see here. So LTE MIMO antenna, vertical polarization, LTE MIMO antenna, horizontal polarization. Okay. So one more thing I wanted to tell you that, as I mentioned before, so pattern diversity, how we can ensure one antenna will operate in vertical polarization, one antenna will operate in another horizontal polarization. Therefore, you can ensure the pattern diversity. So you can see that how many antennas are there. So now antennas are evolved, and you can see that, see, nowadays antennas are in this much size. Okay. Earlier this much size, but now it is going to be this much size in millimeter level. Okay. And this and all we have seen already. So now we'll just talk about, you know, though as we have touched upon this 5G, okay, and now it is not only MIMO, it is also array integrated. So how phased array works? So let's see. So it has two kind of beamforming. One is analog beamforming and digital beamforming. Okay. So here you can see that baseband processing is done, and then it will be fed to several elements at a time. This is called as analog beamforming. Okay. So whereas in digital beamforming, you will process and each data in a separate processing unit, and then you will feed to each element separately. But advantage here is that you are feeding into multiple antennas with the same baseband system. Whereas here you are using individual baseband system for each antenna element. Okay. So therefore, it's a cost wise, it is quite high. Cost wise, it is effective. But the problem is, if you want to change the band, if you want to operate two frequency bands, then it is not possible. Okay. So here it is possible. Okay. So for example, one element in one band, another element in another band, for example, FR1, FR2, then it is possible here. That's why they went for hybrid approach, where initially you implement the digital beamforming, then each output will be fed to analog beamforming unit, and then these beamformings are ensured. Okay. I think this array theory, I think Sir could have covered to you, okay, how beamforming works. So you can see that how beamforming is happening. Okay. Now, having said this, so now in 5G, if you want to take up any work in 5G antenna design, you cannot do antenna design antenna separately. You have to go for a co-simulation with the circuit itself, because you know you are going to design amplifier and many things here there. So you can, if you design antenna separately and amplifier separately, bringing matching between these two, it is very difficult, because all are going to be co-located. So that's why, you know, its co-simulation is going to work. Okay. Here what they are doing is that they will design antenna, import the S parameter of the antenna, and then give it to the amplifier characterization. Then based on this output, then they design optimize. So then they will design and optimize the input and output matching network. It will be fed to this here, and then they will evaluate radiation characteristics, and then this output will be given to the here also. Okay. So it is kind of combined simulation, where radiation characteristics will be evaluated, and your amplifier reflection parameter, okay, scattering parameter will be evaluated. So all will be evaluated. So we'll for getting better radiation pattern and also the matching, that we have to optimize the input and output matching networks in order to get that. Okay. So this is how it will be looking like. You will have input matching network and amplifier output matching network, and you have two element antenna. Okay. And also this is the transmitter, another element. Okay. So here two chains are there. One is the chain one, TX chain one, TX chain two, two are fed to two element antenna. So all will be simulated at a time, so that you know both the performance are ensured properly. Now how the simulation is done? So it can be done with the help of ANSYS, HFSS, or ADA software, or CST, anything. Okay. So here I think I just show how the co-simulation is done using ADS. Okay, KeySight ADS. You can see that they will design amplifier and transmitter baseband circuit in this ADS. And also they will design array, they integrate these two, and then tune the antenna array to tune this element and also the antenna array in order to get the desired beam. Okay, so you can see here that by controlling these parameters, excitation parameter, you can trigger the beam wherever you want. Okay, whichever direction you desire. Okay, this is how simulations are being done. Okay, you can see here that so multiple beams are triggered. You can see that my several beams are triggered, and all those parameters like directivity gain, mean effective gain, and all those parameters are captured in the one go. Okay, so if you excite this one, you'll get a one beam like this. If you excite another, if you excite with the another set of values, then you will get the another kind of beam. Okay, so now this is how simulation is done. Now we will see 5G MIMO antennas. In 5G, as I said before, we are using FR1 and FR2. In this, so this antenna is designed for FR1. Okay, so here what they have done is that the unique thing what they have done is that, see, they are switching the beam, switching the operating frequency, because you will not going to use same carrier frequency for same carrier frequency is not going to be used by all the operators. Each one will use different carrier frequency within the same design within the bandwidth allocated for them. Okay, each cell will have its own frequency, right? So in order to achieve that, they have gone for by using capacitor and voltage diode biasing, they could switch the frequency of operation. For example, you can see here that by controlling the capacitor values, you can switch the frequency of operation, and also the controlling the biasing voltage of the diode, you can switch the frequencies. And pattern, you can see here that this is the radiating in one direction, this is radiating another direction, therefore the pattern diversity is ensured. This is another antenna where you are going to have a FR1 and FR2 antenna operating in same platform, means same board. Okay, so this is operating in FR2 frequency, this is operating in FR1 frequency, and both are fed. You can see here that feed 1 2, feed 1 3 4. Okay, so how the simulator performance of this S parameter characteristics are shown here. You can see that it is in FR1 frequency, this is in FR2 frequency, it is operating in both the bands. Okay, and you can see that isolation is ensured in all the both the frequency bands, FR1 and FR2. So here the design is, see how much complex is this. That's all it would be. Okay, now you have designed antenna, you have designed system. Now how it is going to be measured? Okay, because we have to measure the how MIMO is working, and also the MIMO, massive MIMO array is working. Okay, so for example, your mobile is transmitting beams in different direction, right? That we have to emulate, right? So this is how the chamber would be. In chamber, this is called as OTA chamber, over the air chamber. If you type OTA in internet, you will get a lot of materials. Okay, you can just go through that. Okay, so this is how real-time measurement will happen. Okay, here you can see that the mobile is there. Okay, so how the MIMO properties and also the beam forming properties will be tested in this kind of environment. How they are testing? You are going to place your UE or any antenna at the origin of the sphere. Okay, so in this in the circumference of the sphere, radius of the sphere, you will have either you rotate the probe and then capture the signal and then do the processing, or you will have over their measurement method, you will have multiple antennas will be located in several positions. Then based on this, for example, if you are triggering the beam in this direction, then I will get the signal from here, maximum signal from here, I will get a minimum signal in this other antennas, right? Based on which you will capture the MIMO performance and also the beam forming performance. This is how the measurement would be done. And so real time measurement, how it is done is, see, you can see here that it is called as system, like a 5G emulator. Okay, so where it will have all the 5G base station subsystem and so cellular networks, it will be emulated here, and then you will have a channel propagation also emulated here. Then you are feeding into your mobile, and then you are measuring the what is the performance of a mobile antenna in terms of how MIMO is working, how capacity is enhanced or not. So based on the certain parameters, we can measure within the chamber. Okay, next is that I'm rushing through because I have to cover one more topic also, that's why. Okay, next is that you can see that this is how beamforming is measured. As I mentioned before, you will have a two kind of positioner. You will only have you will not only have a azimuth position rotation and also have the elevation rotation, so that you can capture the beams, each beams separately and then process it. Okay, now coming back to this design and simulation tools, you have MATLAB also. You can design any MIMO system and then you can verify using that. Okay, you have a sum of set up kind of a toolbox and then you can design that using Simulink. You can design a baseband equipment and then you can design antenna using a toolbox and then you integrate it. You can simulate it. Okay, and also for ADS, I think 3D structure also now somehow it is supporting. Okay, you can check with that. ADS, CST, FICO, Empire, so many tools are there, simulation tools. And the testing solution, you can see that, Keysight, Antetsu, R&S, and YAV, NI, so several companies are there, okay. I think, we have seen, let's conclude. We have seen about MIMO, some of the introduction and also the features of MIMO and some of the, how MIMO antenna is being characterized and some of the MIMO antennas also. Then how this MIMO is applied for 5G, how different 5G antennas are designed and how it is being simulated, what are all simulation tools and how it is being measured, we have seen. Okay, that's all from my side for first.